ਪ੍ਰੈਸ ਮੀਟ ਮੁਆਜੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੋਈ ਵੀ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਦਾ ਇਕਨੋਮਿਕ ਅੰਡਰ ਪਰਫਾਰਮੈਂਸ ਐਂਡ ਓਰਿਸਸ ਗ੍ਰੋਥ ਸਟੋਰੀ ਆਪਣ ਜਾਣਿਥ ਰੀਸੈਂਟਲੀ ਜਸਟ ਅ ਫਿਊ ਡੇਜ਼ ਅਗੋ ਦੇਰ ਵਾਜ਼ ਅਨ ਆਈਟਮ ਨਿਊਜ਼ ਆਈਟਮ ਦੈਟ ਜੀ ਡੀ ਪੀਜ਼ ਗ੍ਰੋਥ ਡ੍ਰੋਪ ਟੂ 7.1% ਇਨ ਦੀ ਸੈਕਿੰਡ ਕੁਆਟਰ ਆਫ 2018-19 ਐਂਡ ਦਿਸ ਵਾਜ ਐਜ ਅਗੇਂਸਟ this was reported in many newspapers including Times of India. This is a link that I have given. This is as against 8.2% growth in the first quarter of the same year. So there was a slowdown which is more than 1%. The gross value added, which is another indicator from the supply side, that is the people who supply, the producers, that slowed down to 6.9% against 8% in the earlier quarter. Again, a fall of more than 1%. The growth is expected to remain under pressure and may remain at 7.1% for the full year 2018-19. Pura 2018-19 rate, the growth is expected to remain at 7.1%. Now, this is the news item which came just about 5 days ago. Now, all this thanks to the BJP government's policies at the center. Now, how do we compare? Orissa compares its growth against these kind of projections is the subject matter of today's press conference. Now, what has been said in this news, in this recent statistics is that the GDP fell to 7.1% from 8.2% in the first, in the second quarter. The gross value added again fell by 1.1%. Agricultural growth, which is very important, it also dropped by 1.5%. The financial, real estate, and professional services, someone with that also fell by 0.2%. The mining fell by 2.4%. Electricity, gas, water supply, and other utility services, they also fell by 1.9%. Construction fell by 1.1%. Now, these are statistics which has been generated by the National Statistical Organization, the Central Statistical Organization, CSOI's figures. Now, the COSI figures finally form the backbone for all RBI projections that you must be aware of. Now, the other forecasts which have also been there about the Indian economy is that the IMF pares it down to 7.3% from 7.4%. The Moody's Investor Service, which is basically reflecting the investor sentiment in the country, that has said that it will grow at 7.4% in 18 to slow down to 7.3% next year. The Standard & Poor's S&P, which is also an indicator of confidence in the economy, that says that the real GDP dropped to 6.67% from 7.1% a year earlier. So as you can see, there is a decline on all fronts. Now, again, just a few days ago, I think it is about 2 days ago, Dirinaguru, there was a new calculation which came, which was released by the central government, particularly by the Niti Aayog, which said that we have done the back calculation based on the revised base year. The base year earlier was 2004-05. They revised it to 2011-12 as a part of national account statistics. But the point is, what it did, as you will see in the next slide, is that you know, there are two estimates which came. One came in 17th August 2018. This was done by the National Institute for Public Finance and Policy, NIPFP's Dr. Vanumurthy. Now that showed, which was in August 2018, just 6 months ago, which showed that the UPA2's figures were higher than what was there earlier, by the same back-end calculation. And the figures were like this, that it was showing an improved performance in many of the fields, many of the years, when you do the revised ratio calculation. But the government said that they were not satisfied, methodologically this was probably not sound. And now Niti Aayog in 29th November 2018, which is just spent on various health, education, poverty, employment, these are the aspects. Now, social sector development expenditure includes that. Now, social sector expenditure is only social sector, but doesn't include economic services, infrastructure. Now, the CAG generates these figures, which you can find in the state finance reports of Orissa, as well as any other state, which is available in the websites of the CAG, www.cag.gov.in for every state you find. We have compiled that. You can see that in 2012-13, the general category states, not the special category states, the general category states, the development expenditure as a percentage of aggregate expenditure, kind of total expenditure, was 70%. And Orissa was spending 123.8%. In 16-17, the figures for which are available with the CAG, 17-18 not yet generated and not yet placed in the assembly, the figure is 78.9%, which basically means that a substantial amount of expenditure of the state is spent on developmental efforts and not on non-developmental efforts like general services. General services could be, generally general services are included in police administration, general services includes salaries, general administration, general services would also include maybe sports and youth. But the developmental expenditure, if you look at this figure, 78.9 in 2016-17, compared to any other state that I have mentioned, some are very huge, some are very small, is higher than anybody else. So, what I'm trying to arrive at or convey is that during the period that this government has been in power, the expenditure that has been incurred on development per se, development, what are the breakups, the components of development, I'll come in the next columns, has been higher than many states in the country. Now, this is the kind of growth that one should aspire for. Now, if you look at the social sector expenditure, on particularly the social schemes that are there, in 2012-13, it was 38.2% of the aggregate expenditure for the general category states. Orissa was spending 36.7%, a shade lower. But come 2016-17, we are spending more than what the general category states are spending on the social sector. It is generally believed that the social sector is meant for the poor and the downtrodden and the people who are disadvantaged in society. Now, if you look at the other states, the biggest states, very few are higher than us, but most of them are substantially lower than us. Now, if you look at the capital expenditure, CE by AE, capital expenditure, as you know, is what creates assets, durable assets. Now, people might think that you are spending money on non-durable revenue kind of expenditure, which will not have a return on a long term for the state. Now, if you look at capital expenditure as a percentage of aggregate expenditure, it was 12.8 into 12 and 13.
लेटेस्ट अपडेट वीडियो देखिबा पई आम चैनल को लाइक करंतु, सब्सक्राइब करंतु, बेल आइकन ले प्रेस करंतु ओ शेयर मध्य करंतु।